now that we understand or recall how to plot the equation of a line and how to get the equation of a line from a point and a slope, now we're going to learn about the regression line. Okay, this is a variation. The regression line is defined as the best line as it fits closest to all of the points in a scatter plot. Okay. In particular, it fits such that it minimizes the sum of the squared residuals. It's written here, minimizes the sum of the squared residuals. Okay, what am I talking about? What are residuals? Here's a scatter plot of data. And just to give you an idea what we're aiming for, we're going to try and find the line that fits closest to all the points as a representative of those points so that it can be used in cases when I want to make a prediction. For instance, I don't know the value of y when x is here. Okay, so when x is here, I don't have any points in the data for when x is here. In fact, in all of this range, I don't know what y would be. Okay, neither do I know it in this range. So what we can do is find this line using the points that we do have that were observed, and it will replace or it'll be used to make my prediction. Let's start with points that we do have. These are observed values. Okay, let's look at those observed values and let's use them to define what a residual is and then the least squares regression line. So this is a value of x, and for this value of x, y took this value and y took this value. Okay, so these are the heights for when x was x, blue x. So we refer to, let's take this point, and this one here. So for this observation, when x is the blue x, y is y observed for x. Okay, so we would write that this is the height of y for the observed value. X. Okay. This value, however, on the line also, when x is little blue x, when this is the case, this is known as the predicted value of y. Okay, so I've taught you about y observed, y predicted. And you see, this predicted value is wrong. It's not exactly predicting this observation, is it? So because it's off, there's an error involved in that. The error we are interested in, okay? The error actually has a special name. We call it the residual, and it's the distance here. The error, the residual, what's left over, these are different ways of thinking about it. So to calculate a residual, in this case, the residual should indicate that the observed value is below the predicted value. And the way that we do that is we take y observed minus y predicted and calculate the residual, which will turn out to be a negative because the observed value is smaller. So in fact, all the points for all of the observations below the line, residuals calculated to the line, will be negative. So all out here, we have negative residuals below the line. Above the prediction line, then the residuals will be positive. So what we do have then If we were to calculate residuals for all the observed values, there's a residual for this one, there's a residual for that one, the residual for this one. If this was the least squares regression line, the residual here would be zero. There's residuals for each of these values. So you imagine strings to the line. I can draw those in. So these red lines represent the residuals, the length of the residuals. And we can see, remembering that the residuals above the line are positive, the residuals below are negative, we can think now about trying to make those red pieces of string as small as possible. We want to lay the line, in other words, we want to lay down the regression line to be that line such that we have the least or minimized total red string. So if you were to attach all those pieces of string together, the least squares regression line would be the line that produced the smallest combined red string. Okay, so you can imagine if we were to do this, that we'd have to do this by hand. We'd have to fit a line, to get the red string, measure it and see if it's good enough, get another red, take another line, shift it a little bit in one direction and see what happens to the red line. If it gets bigger, we shift it down. If it gets smaller, we shift it up. However the case, we inch towards being the line with the smallest total pieces of red string. As complex as that sounds, you will not have to do that. The fact is that calculus does that for us, and calculus turns out some very simple results that we're going to use. So you just need to remember those results so that you can apply them. What you should remember, though, is that in minimizing the total line, something's going to happen that should sound familiar. What's going to happen is that this line, because it needs to fit closest to all the points, it has to pass through the mean, a point that is the mean in both directions. So it must pass through a point that is x bar, y bar, okay? Because x bar is closest, is one value that's closest to all the points in the x direction, and y bar is a value that's closest to all the points in the y direction, okay? So this line is going to float through x bar, y bar, and since that's the case, now I want you to think about what we learned about the mean and the mean of a distribution. The mean is the center of gravity. As the center of gravity, it sits perfectly between the values so that the weight of the values on one side equally balance off the weight of the values on the other side. So it takes note of the distance of the values from the mean on one side and the distance of the values from the mean on the other side. Okay, and we had an issue when we were trying to calculate some idea of deviations from the mean, remember, in calculating the variance and then the standard deviation. Because calculating deviations from the mean results in a total of deviations that if you were to add them together, they cancel each other out. Well, in this case, if I was to add together these pieces of string, that's one thing. But if I added together the residuals, which was the pieces of string with their sign, making these ones negative and the ones on top positive, what would happen by adding them together is they would cancel each other out, just like when I try and calculate the average of deviations from the mean. So if you remember, what we did in that situation was we squared the deviations from the mean. In this case, we're going to have to square residuals and minimize the sum of squared residuals. And that is the definition of the least squares prediction line.